Hello, my name is Susan Nelson. I've run my own businesses over the last 25 years. My last business was a finalist in the Small Business of the Year Awards. But it was a worry, 7 days a week, 12 hours a day. When things went well, it was great, but I was still tied to the business and it needed input from me most days. I wanted to get the business running well without me having to be there a lot of the time. I wanted to work on the business, not in it. The hardest challenge I ever had was taking the time to set up some standards about how I wanted the business to run. It took time and effort. I have to say the result was amazingly exactly what I'd written down and planned for in my business plan. The business ran better than ever, the employees were happy most of the time, and I finally had more free time, with the benefit of still paying myself a wage. As someone who has weathered the storm of a few serious problems in the day-to-day running of a business, I'm well aware of the need to protect yourself in your business. You need to know the basic legal requirements of running a business. Put a few basic procedures together to make your business less likely to go under because of costs relating to trouble with employees, safety in the workplace, bullying or unfair dismissal cases, just to mention a few possibilities. Do you feel totally overwhelmed? You're so busy with the basic running of the business, you can't even think about adding any more work to your day, let alone more paperwork. I completely understand, that's exactly how I felt. But what if I told you procedures could change your life? If you can make the time to understand about putting a plan into place for your business, it can change how you think. You open yourself up to learning more, and a change in you makes a change in your business. There's no going back then. Improve your knowledge, improve your business. Communication and writing things down lessens the problems that can happen. I'm going to quickly run through the basics that I think your business should have. Your USP, unique selling point. What is it your business is about? What's different about your business to others dealing with the same product or service? What is it you want your clients to experience when they deal with your business? What are the benefits of dealing with you? Write down for the clients and the employees to see. What are your team values for your employees? What rules do you expect them to uphold when you're not around? Honesty, hard work, reporting problems to management and not gossiping to other employees. The customer comes first. We strive to be the best we can be. You can't assume that your employees will think like you. You need to communicate to them so that they understand what you want. Standard letter of employment and standard job descriptions. Write it down now so you don't end up arguing about it later. A few standard pieces of paperwork aid in protecting you from arguments or misunderstandings that may end up in court proceedings against you. Standard training policies. For the main safety hazards in your business, get them signed and dated by each employee to show that you're trying to do the right thing by them and the law. One signature could potentially save you or your insurance company tens of thousands of dollars in a workers' compensation situation. Training employees. Spend time training the people you employ and see the benefits to your business. People want to know exactly what to do and how you want them to do it. They don't want to get it wrong. Training people makes them more effective in your business, and they also get the benefit of becoming a more highly skilled employee. Something they will appreciate and something that will encourage their loyalty to you. Training and valuing your employees keeps them in your business longer, and it reduces your retraining costs. Employees continually leaving negatively affects the business efficiency and profit. Did you know it's a legal requirement to have a wages book for even one employee? You must also give that employee a detailed pay slip showing superannuation, holiday loading, etc. A wages book can protect you by showing an exact record of your employee's work history in case of injury or illness. There are some policies you must have if you have a business. Let's just mention three: anti-discrimination, bullying, and privacy. One paragraph for each, and you're demonstrating your business is aware of these legal issues, and you are reducing the risk of misunderstandings in the workplace that could have you thousands of dollars out of pocket. A marketing plan. Everyone needs it. It's not something that you can leave out of your business. Make it easy. Part of marketing is having policies in your business to ensure your employees are doing what you expect them to. Otherwise, what's the point of marketing to get more busy? Your clients and your employees can see by the way you run your business whether or not they can trust you and recommend you to others. Write down 12 marketing ideas you can put into place, one each month over the next 12 months. Record it all on one page, put it in your diary, and do it without fail at the beginning of every month. Try it. A business plan. Set aside 1 hour to write down a brief business plan. Business growth centres have a standard document. Just download it from this website. Just fill it in. You can get help step by step if you think that would help you get on track and get it done. There is help out there for small business owners. When you actually write down your business goals and put the necessary steps into action, making sure you continually do what you planned, you can eventually start to see what you envisaged fall into place. Try it. You just might surprise yourself. Good luck.